A very warm welcome to you all. Welcome you to the All Saints Church. And just really, really grateful to the church here for hosting us this afternoon. My name is Narinda. I know that many of you know who I am, and some of my team members are here too, Sean and Philip. I welcome you all, those who are present and those who are watching from their homes far and near, for this year's service to remember and to give thanks for our special babies who are no longer with us. At last, we can be together face to face, but I just ask you just to be cautious, to wear your masks, and to be with your family unit. I would be really grateful for that. We are able to sing if you want to join in with the hymn Fleetingly Known, and it's to the music, to the song, to the music For Morning Has Broken, which we're all quite familiar with. You join in if you feel able to. And as we remember our babies, we also remember others who have been in our lives, whom we love and hold in our hearts today. I'd like to extend my grateful thanks to all who have given their time generously to support this service. And for the fear of leaving someone out, I won't mention individual names, apart from the musicians who have given their time so generously, to Emily, to Amanda, and to Jude, who has stepped in at the 11th hour to sing the solo. So thank you so much for all the hard work that you've put in. So let's just take a moment now to still ourselves as we gather ourselves with our own thoughts and the things that we are holding on. For each life we have known, for each tear that has been shed, and for the pain that we feel and that we have felt because we have loved, we give thanks for every memory of the love and the joy, for every memory of the life that we have known, for every sorrow that was shared with us. We give thanks. Christmas, as we know, is a time of celebration, but it's also a time of sadness for many of us, as we remember loved ones who are no longer with us, their precious lives, no matter how short, have made an impact on our lives and brought us love and joy, grief and pain, dreams and hopes that were never fulfilled. Their life and death has touched all who have been part of their lives. We feel differently and think differently because of them, and we will never be the same again. As we come together today, there is a oneness of spirit. We come with a common experience and a bond which unites us all. God of all, we come here together as people from different backgrounds, different ways of life, to share in this time to remember our children, our babies. And so we keep a moment of silence before we have our first reading.
For you created my innermost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days adorned for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them.
Loving God, we thank you that each one of us are known to you and that we are precious to you, that we are all fearfully and wonderfully made. We thank you for the opportunity to come together today, to be with each other, to give support, to hear each other's stories. We thank you for all those who have journeyed with us thus far. Be with us in this season, in the joys and the sorrows. And we thank you for our lives and for each other. Amen.
For a Child Born Dead by Elizabeth Jennings. What ceremony can we fit you into now? If you'd come out of a warm and noisy room to this, there'd be an opposite for us to know you by. we could imagine you in lively mood, and then look at the other side, the mood drawn out of you, the breath defeated by the power of death. But we have never seen you stride ambitiously the world we know. You could not come, and yet you go. But there is nothing now to mar your clear refusal of our world. Not in our memories can we mould you or distort your character. Then all our consolation is that grief can be as pure as this.
We are connected. We are connected, my child and I, by an invisible cord not seen by the eye. It's not like the cord that connects us till birth. This cord can't be seen by any on earth. This cord does its work right from the start. It binds us together, attached to my heart. I know that it's there, though no one can see the invisible cord from my child to me. The strength of this cord is hard to describe. It can't be destroyed. It can't be denied. It's stronger than any cord man could create. It withstands the test, can hold any weight. And though you are gone, though you're not here with me, the cord is still there, but no one can see. It pulls at my heart. I am bruised, I am sore, but this cord is my lifeline, as never before. I am thankful that we connect this way, a mother and child. Death can't take it away.
Thank you. pebbles on the beach are a result of erosion. The unique form of this pebble, a result of the wind, water, and other rocks and sand that have shaped it. As I look at you now, I see the outer appearance, but not what has shaped you. The events of your life so far, the significant relationships, the gains and the losses, things that have ground you down, and the things that have lifted you up. I do not know your story and what has brought you here today. But I wanted to share some reflections on loss from my own brief time working as an assistant chaplain at the RUH. As chaplains, our job is to walk alongside our fellow human beings, knowing that there are paths which can only be walked alone. One of the hardest things I have witnessed is the pain of families like yours who have lost a baby, lost a part of themselves, the daughter, the son, the grandchild, the future that they have dreamt of and longed for. No words can fill that space. Here today, we remember those lives. This place is filled with the memory of them. In remembering them, we recognize how fragile life is. What a miracle it is that we are here at all, together in this place right now, breathing in and breathing out. Feeling what is in our heart, acknowledging the pain in our neighbor's heart. In this raw and vulnerable place, we know what it is to be human, what it is to love, and to lose what we love. As Christmas draws near, I'm mindful for all of you and so many others for different reasons. It's a painful time, regardless of whether we have a faith or not. It is bittersweet. But what is remarkable about the Christmas story is that the all-powerful God and Creator came to Earth in the form of a baby. A baby that was weak and helpless, and who symbolized hope. A baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. In the words of the carol, the hopes and fears of all these years are met in thee tonight. We know too how that story ends, with a mother looking on helplessly as her son is nailed to a tree. Mary's joy turned to grief. Grief is often described as a dark place, and the death of a child a very dark place. And it is into that place of darkness and disorientation that we will shortly light candles. As you receive lighted candles this afternoon, may the light guide you as you take the next step on your grief journey. The Christmas message is that the light has come and continues to shine in this world. There is hope. And furthermore, that hope does not end with this life. The light does not stop here, but continues to shine with the hope of the light of heaven. life and light continuing even beyond death. If you come from a different faith tradition, maybe you have a different festival of light, which is special for you in a similar way. The lighted candle you will receive this afternoon is for your child, as we are reminded that light and life continue beyond death. And the pebble in my hand, a reminder of all that has shaped you, which will never be forgotten.
at the rising of the sun and its going down, we remember them.
At the blowing of the wind and in the chill of winter,
we remember them. At the opening of the buds and in the rebirth of spring, we remember them.
At the blueness of the skies and in the warmth of summer,
we remember them. At the beginning of the year and when it ends,
we remember them. When we are weary and in need of strength,
we remember them. At Christmas, birthdays and anniversaries, we remember them.
When we have joy we crave to share,
we remember them. When we have decisions that are difficult to make, we remember them.
As long as we live, they too will live, for they are now a part of us.
We remember them.
advice, doctors and surgeons, family and friends, colleagues and neighbours. We hold in our hearts all today who find life just too
difficult to bear, too overwhelming to embrace. May the love that is eternal embrace all who are in need this day. May the love that is eternal embrace each of us. Fill us, flow through us, and out to others today and always. Amen. I invite you to join me as we say together the prayer on the sheet. Dear God, into your hands we commend these precious children and entrust them to your merciful keeping. Reassure us that our children rest in your love. Be near to them and to us today and forevermore. Be our strength and guide. Lead us to know your healing and your peace and joy. Amen.
Thank you.
God of all, be with us and with our families and friends on our life journey. Give us courage to live through the pain, strength to care, and give love, even when it is difficult, and the energy we need to live our lives. And may your blessing and peace be with us now, and with those whom we love, and those whom we continue to love, but see no more, and cherish in our hearts. Amen. So the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you his peace this day and in the days ahead. Amen. Before we conclude our service, I just want to make an apology to you because we have put in the service that there will be refreshments. But sadly, we're not able to share in refreshments in this climate at this moment. So our sincere apologies for that. Just to say that if you wanted to light another candle, you are most welcome. And thank you so much for coming today and joining with us. Just ask you now just to take care of yourself as you leave this place. It's been a very emotional afternoon. So just be kind to yourself. And just again, a very big thank you to All Saints Church who have hosted us and made us feel so welcome. We're so grateful. Thank you.